I'm going to guide you on how to turn your Windows 7 to 8.1 with this pack of programs, and I'll show you the final result by the end of this video. Here is the Windows 7, and by downloading the transformation pack, the link will be in the description of this video, you'll get certain apps and tweaks that you must do to transform the OS. Before you transform the OS, be sure to download your Extras by clicking the second link in the description of this video and install it as what you would usually do when installing applications. This application will allow some extended customization to the Windows installation. By extracting the zip file to wherever file you want to, which in this one I'll choose the download folder, you'll see that you can apply the theme out of the box by copying the folder of whichever theme you want to install, either with user picture or not, to c:\windows\resources\themes. And simply one step in the personalization applet, you can experience the look of Windows 8.1 in Windows 7, such as the rectangle window border, flat caption box, as well as thick window border. And by that, be sure to like and subscribe. Thank you to all my supporters. Just kidding, there's more for us to do to complete the transformation. We'll start with the easiest out of all, the font. Windows 8.1 has a different variation of Segoe UI, which indicates a more sans feel to it rather than a serif font. By installing all the available font files and restarting, you will see some minor differences in some letters, as you can see, such as in the Windows Explorer and the Start menu. Next one, the Start menu and user picture frame. This is the most obvious clue that this is Windows 7, and you can change it by downloading Customizer God with the third link in the description. Oh, oh yeah, make sure that Microsoft .NET Framework 4.5 or higher is installed on your Windows 7 installation. Now, you can change it with the proper resources available from the package, and the application will automatically change them for you. But what you can't do automatically is when you lose your data. Ever wonder when you accidentally format your disk or flash drive, and you really want to get the file back? No worries, as we got EasyOS Data Recovery Wizard for you. EasyOS Data Recovery Wizard can recover your data due to accidentally formatting a drive, a virus attack, or partition loss. I personally use it whenever I stupidly formatted my 32GB SanDisk Crystal Blade before I copied my files for my video. Yeah, and thankfully, using advanced scan, I can get my files back and return to make videos as usual. Check out the link in the description of this video as well as the pinned comment to try EasyOS Data Recovery Wizards to start recovering your data right now. Moving along, the user account picture. Oh boy, this is just as easy as going to the control panel and changing the user picture via user account applet, and it's really easy as heck. Looking at the Windows Explorer, the navigation buttons are still using that glowing arrow design from Windows 7. You can change it by taking over the Explorer frame.dll's ownership in the System 32 directory. But how can we do it? Follow what's shown in the video. After that, rename the file to back it up, such as explorer_frame_o.dll, and copy the batch file to the system32 folder. And by logging off and logging back on, you can see the change has affected the OS. And then, control panel. We can see that the task pane is still having that gradient from Windows 7. We can fix this by taking over shell32.dll's ownership, like what we did with explorer_frame.dll. Backing it up like what we did before and replacing it with the patch 1 by using command prompt as administrator. Copy the file path of the patch file first and kill explorer.exe. Don't worry, it is safe. Use the copy command by pasting the patch shell32.dll's directory in quotation, and then type c:\windows\system32\shell32.dll. When it's finished, type explorer.exe and restart the computer. Now, the last sip in a cup, the logon screen. By using the same taking ownership method for shell32.dll to authui.dll for this x86 version, but the difference in here is you must rename the file using command prompt as administrator, like what I did exactly in here. If you don't, you will lose the ability to run any process as administrator. Using the same copying file method, by copying the patch files path in quotation and the original path after that, changing the logon background to the Windows 8.1 default with tweaks logon, and voila! Restarting the computer and there's a new logon screen. Now that you've finished transforming Windows 7 to Windows 8.1, here's the first Windows 7 look. And here's a transform look. Pretty interesting, right? You can still use your Windows 7 with your beloved programs, files, and services whilst updating the look to what people say is more modern, albeit there are some hiccups here and there. And by that, you're probably interested too in this Windows Me. Well, is this Windows Me? Then check out this video. Meanwhile, thank you to my supporters for making this video possible, and also don't forget to check out this video.